If Mr. De La Serna will not answer the question of the Honorable Paduano, I will move that we cite him in contempt. There's nothing involving national security for him not to answer the query of the Honorable Paduano.
Second, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Akop. Mr. De La Serna, this is your last warning. Please answer the query of Congressman Paduano. Oh, Mr. De La Serna, meron ka pang opportunity before we rule on the motion to cite you in contempt. Pwede bang sagutin mo yung tanong ni Congressman Paduano? Ang taon ka naging executive assistant ni Attorney Harry Roque?
I was an executive assistant to the Office of the Presidential Spokesperson from January of 2021 to November 15 of 2021 po, Mr. Chair.
So, 2020 to 2021? Tama ba yung pagkakalit?
Mali po, Your Honor. Mr. Chair, January of 2021 until November 15 of 2021 po.
So January 2021 up to November of 2021, wala pang isang taon.
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Okay, did you apply for that position? Anong position mo sa office ni spokesman Attorney Harry Roque?
I was an executive assistant to the Office of the Presidential Spokesperson po, Mr. Chair.
And what do you exactly do in the office of Attorney Harry Roque?
Nag-start po ako as social media. Ako po yung nag-handle ng SOCMED po ni Attorney Roque po, Mr. Chair.
Okay, yung bang item na executive assistant ay item under the office of the spokesperson?
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
So, anong salary grade niyan?
I'm not sure if it is salary grade 17 or 20 po, Mr. Chair.
Okay, sige. Salamat. Yung bang last hearing, sinasabi ni Attorney Harry Roque that you being his executive assistant, ikaw ang mga kasama niya sa travels. Kasi nga is diabetic ba? Tama ba ako dun?
Ang dami niya pong sakit, Mr. Chair.
Okay. And nurse ka ba?
Hindi po, Mr. Chair.
Meron ka bang background sa medicine?
No po, Mr. Chair.
Ilan kayo executive assistant sa office ni Attorney Harry Roque?
Alam ko po, madami po siyang staff po, but the EA post is until EA 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 po.
And you are EA?
EA 3 po ako, Mr. Chair.
EA 3?
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Okay, so yung EA 1, EA 2, sinasama rin ba ni Attorney Harry Roque sa travels abroad?
EA, based on my knowledge, Mr. Chair, yung nakabiyahe lang po na EA is EA 3, ako po yun, EA 2, and the EA 5 po.
Okay.
EA 4 din po pala, Mr. Chair.
EA 1, 2, 3, and 4?
No po, Mr. Chair. 2, 3, 4, 5 po, Mr. Chair.
2, 3, 4, and 5. EA, ang daming EA pala, no? No office ng spokesperson?
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Okay, and your job description ay you handle the social media of the spokesperson as well as his travel companion. Kasama ba yon sa job description mo?
Nung nag-start po kasi ako kay Sir Harry po, Mr. Chair, there was no post in Malacanang. That's why I first handled this social media po, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Salamat sa sagot mo. Alam mo rin ba na it seems kasi na you're very, very close to Attorney Harry Roque, tama?
Yes po, Mr.
Can you say that among all the executive assistants, ikaw ang closest to Attorney Harry Roque?
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Is that the reason kung bakit ginawa ka niyang incorporator sa isang kumpanya niya?
Mr. Chair, to my knowledge on that po, Mr. Chair, it was Attorney Val po na nagpa-sign po sa akin that time kasi kailangan na po nila nang magko-complete po sa corporation po nila.
Sige.
you mentioned that there's at least one more corporation kung saan nakapangalan ka bilang either nominal stakeholder or board of directors. So, Mr. Chair, if I may ask, Mr. De La Serna, pwede mo bang pangalanan kung ano pa yung ibang corporation na dati ka naging board of director or stockholder o kasalukuyan ka pang board of director or stockholder, Mr. Chair?
Good. Yes po.
Pakilapit nga yung microphone, please.
You've had 2 hours already, Mr. De La Serna.
Yes,
sabi
po,
ko, paki-check
Honor.
Na.
The name of the company is Block 19 Lot 89.
Pakilapit yung microphone.
The name is Block 19 Lot 89, Phase 2 Pinewoods Village Incorporated po, Your Honor. I can send you the copy po if you want.
Mr. Chair, I believe that's the address. What's the name of the corporation? It's the name of the corporation?
Corporate name, yun ba, Your Honor?
No.
I can give you the copy po, Your Honor. The name, the corporate name is Block 19, Lot 89, Phase 2, Pinewoods Village Incorporated po.
Mr. Chair, under oath, may I ask Mr. De La Serna, aside from the two mentioned, Biancham and the one mentioned now, Block, I didn't catch the name. Aside from those two, are there other corporations that you are either a board of director of or a stockholder? Under oath ka, Mr. A.R. De La Serna.
To my knowledge po, ito lang po, Your Honor.
So I'm member ng board of directors ng Biancham, na ang Biancham po ay pumasok sa isang partnership sa Green Mile Realty Corporation.
Yes po, Your Honor.
Aware po kayo?
Yes po.
So, naaalala niyo po na pumirma po kayo ng dokumento na pumapayag po na pumasok ang Biancham sa partnership po sa Green Mile Realty Corp.
Alam ko may pinirman ang document but I'm not sure it was a partnership with Green something po. Hindi ako sure.
So, binabawi niyo po yung kanina?
Alam ko may pinirmahan akong document but I cannot fully say na it was with Green. Yun po yung sinabi niya.
Mr. Chair, I highlight this because one of the key principal projects of the partnership between Green Mile Realty Corp. and Biancham, which then became FBMHC or the first Bataan Mariveles Holding Corporation, is to develop a plot of land in Mariveles, Bataan with the size of 422 hectares, o yung tinatawag po na Mariveles land. And the development project was valued at 1.8 billion pesos. Mr. A.R. De La Serna, kayo po ay sumasang-ayon na ang 1.8 billion pesos ay malaking halaga po.
Yes po, Your Honor.
Napakalaking halaga po nun. At alam niyo po ba kung saan kinuha ng Biancham yung ganito kalaki na pondo para po mabili ang ganitong 1.8 billion pesos na lupa?
To be honest po, Your Honor, I did not know the transactions of Biancham po.
My apologies, Mr. Chair. Mr. De La Serna, can you please repeat?
To be honest po, Your Honor, I do not know the activities of Biancham po.
Mr. Chair, I feel like the recurring theme here is Mr. A.R. De La Serna signs documents as the board of director without any knowledge or without reading the subject matter. May I ask po, let's say dumating yung dokumento sa harap nyo, sino po ang kinukonsulta nyo? Na pwede ko ba itong pirmahan? Hindi ko ito pwedeng
pirmahan. Attorney Percival Ortega po, I have full trust and confidence to Attorney Percival Ortega po, Your Honor.
Sino ulit si Attorney Percival Ortega at bakit bukod sa ipinakilala siya sa iyo ni Attorney Harry Roque, bakit napakalaki ng pagtitiwala mo sa kay Mr. Percival Ortega?
Okay naman po kausap si Attorney Val po, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, may I also, I guess ang parati ko pong naiisip dito ay yung Padeho po sa sinasabi ni Ms. Materna doon sa mga dati nating tanong na pumipirma lang ng pumipirma. Pero sige po, ang tanong ko po, kinukonsulta niyo po ba si Attorney Harry Roque kapag kayo ay pumipirma ng mga dokumento sa Biancham?
Ang kinukonsult ko po, Madam, Your Honor, is si Attorney Percival Ortega po.
Kahit employer mo si Attorney Harry Roque at ibinalik mo yung shares na galing na nasa sayo papunta sa kanyang asawa, hindi ba nag-ibig sabihin noon na share nila yon bago ilipat sa'yo, kaya kailangan mo siyang konsultahin sa mga desisyon patungkol sa Biancham?
Sorry po, hindi ko nag-gets yun.
Kasi po, ulitin ko po, di ba may one share ka sa Biancham? Alam mo ba kanino galing yung share na yon?
No, Your Honor.
Bakit kanina, nung tinatanong ka namin, ang sagot mo, binalik ko po yung share kay Mrs. Myla Roque? Hindi ba ibig sabihin nun, alam mo, nagaling din kay Mrs. Roque yung share na nabigay sa'yo?
What I mean sa binabalik ko, Your Honor, is alam ko na completing share holder lang po talaga ako doon. I do not own anything doon. I have not invested on it. So, binabalik ko lang po kung sino yung sabihin ni Attorney Percival Ortega po, Your Honor.
Matanong ko lang po, nung panahon po na nasa Biancham kayo, active pa po ba si Attorney Harry Roque doon sa mga aktibidades ng Biancham? To your knowledge, did he attend any of the meetings? Meron ba siyang...
Maski ako po, Your Honor, wala po akong inatinan na meeting po ng Biancham. So, hindi ko po alam kay Attorney Roque if nag-attend po siya.
So, Mr. Chair, I believe we have established here that Mr. A.R. De La Serna is a stockholder of Biancham by name, entered into agreements without any knowledge of these agreements. So, by name lang po talaga ay nandun siya. At huling tanong po, Mr. Chair, if I may, do you have any relationship with any other corporation registered with the SEC, either as a stockholder or as a member of the board of directors, bukod po sa Biancham?
Ang alam ko, I guess, hindi ako sure po, Your Honor. I guess for the... Pwede ko i-check yung emails ko po.
Mr. Chair...
Alam ko, meron pong isa pa. I'm not sure if ano po yun. Nag-sign lang din po ako noon, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, this is a very important question. Wala ng ibang kumpanya na ikaw ay pumirma ng incorporation documents?
There's one more, to my knowledge po, Your Honor.
What is the name of the other corporation?
Hindi ako sure, Your Honor, but I know in myself na mayroon pa akong isang pinirmahan po.
This is critical, Mr. De La Serna. We need to know what other corporation you're a part of. And sino ulit yung nagpapirma sa'yo ng incorporation or...
Same po, Attorney Percival Ortega pa rin po, Your Honor.
Ano ang relasyon ni Mr. Percival Ortega kay Attorney Harry Roque?
There are law classmates po, Your Honor.
Law classmates. At nung pinakilala ka, gawin mong stockholder, sinabi na si AR na lang yung kunin mo na...
Yes, Your Honor. To complete the requirement of the corporate law po, Your Honor.
Is that the same case with this other corporation?
Yes po, Your Honor.
May you please let us know the name of that corporation?
Hindi ako sure. Sorry po, I do not know po, Your Honor. To be honest, hindi ko po alam. Pero alam ko, aside from Biancham, may isa pa akong C9 po na document.
Anong industry, anong sector ng other corporation na yon?
To be honest po, Your Honor, hindi ako sure if anong company po yun. In what industry?
Mr. Chair, I don't know, this is very important, but I hope that Mr. De La Serna can furnish us, Mr. Chair, with the name of that other corporation. Because, Mr. Chair, my concern is if he's signing documents for Biancham Corporation without knowing the nature of these documents, he most likely is also... Pumipirma ka din ba ng mga papel para doon sa isang korporasyon na yon?
Parang once lang yun, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, sorry, babalik lang ako sa tanong ni Kong Jinky kanina. Ngayon na hindi ka na employed under the office of the presidential spokesperson as an EA, what is your relationship with Attorney Harry Roque now?
Previous employer po si Attorney Roque po. I maintain a professional relationship with my previous employers po, Your Honor.
Bakit po kayo in-endorse ni Attorney Harry Roque kay Ms. Cassie Ong na magstay po sa Lucky 99 compound?
I was not endorsed by Attorney Roque po. Na-introduce niya po ako. Ako po yung kumausap kay Ma'am Cassandra Leong if pwede akong magstay sa lodging houses po nila in Porac.
Pero paano mo nakilala si Ms. Cassie Ong?
Through the introduction of Attorney Roque po, Your Honor.
So, nag-approach ka lang sa kanya after the fact, na after kayo in-introduce, hindi ka in-endorse tulad ng ibang mga pagkakataon na in-endorse kayo ni Attorney Harry Roque kay Ms. Cassie Ong na
kasi dun,
pakipasok si AR sa
ang
nangyari compound?
Kasi doon, Your Honor, was nagtanong po sa akin si Ma'am Cassandra if ano ang ginagawa ko po sa Pampanga. Then I was very honest with her that I was looking for a place to stay because I'll be starting my flying school soon. And sabi naman niya they have lodging houses in I know in my knowledge it was Angeles, not even Porac. So
he signed the documents that allowed him to become a stakeholder of Biansham in 2020 when he was approached by Mr. Percival Ortega by endorsement by Mr. Harry Roque. He did so and agreed to become a stockholder by name without any promise of a dividend, a salary, and without any buy-in. So pumayag po siya na will make you a stockholder by name without any responsibilities, without any buy-in into the company, Mr. Chair.
Please answer. Hindi naman mahirap sagutin yung tanong ni Congresswoman Swansing. Mr. De La Serna?
Mr. Chair, medyo matagal na kasi yung time. I cannot remember if I was given anything that time, to be honest po. So, hindi ko po maalala if I was given compensation or not, but I cannot assume that I was given compensation po. Yun po yung sagot ko.
But were you promised salary or any form of compensation when you signed the document?
Mr. Chair, hindi, I am not sure po if I was given, because that was in 2020 po.
Okay,
Mr. Chair,
proceed.
If I will sign a document as important as that, becoming a nominal stakeholder, not just a stockholder, actually, you're a nominal stockholder as per the documents submitted by Biansham Holdings and Trading Inc. For me, that is such a substantial document to sign. And even though, for example, 10 years ago, I would know if I received a sum or I would know whether I will be offered a salary, Mr. Chair. So I refuse to believe, Mr. Chair, that Mr. A.R. De La Serna does not remember whether he was compensated. But Mr. Chair, let me add another point. If you don't remember whether you received any compensation at the time or not, since, let me ask another question, are you still affiliated with Biansham Holdings now?
No, Your Honor.
How long were you a nominal stockholder of Biansham?
Within this year po, Your Honor, nag-sign na po ako kasi kinuha na po siya ng family ni Attorney Roque. I am not allowed to say anything kasi hindi mo na ko part ng family nila, but they are fixing it already now. Tapos nagpa-sign na sila ng papers sa amin that they are getting my share.
My apologies, Mr. Chair. Let me ask for a clarificatory question. Would you mind repeating that, Mr. De La Serna? You said that the stocks were taken away from you. When and by who? You mentioned it already.
I am not sure if I am allowed to speak about it, Your Honor, because it is not yet final. Hindi ako sure if it is already executed, but already assigned a document. I'm not sure what document, what was that. Pero pinapirma po siya sa akin, giving my share to Ma'am Myla Roque po, the wife of Attorney Roque.
So, Mr. Chair, for my colleagues here were saying they didn't hear. So, you already signed documents now transferring your shares back to Mrs. Roque. Is that correct?
Yes, correct, Your Honor.
May you please let us know the first name of Mrs. Roque?
Mrs. Myla Roque po, Your Honor.
Myla.
Yes.
Myla. So you transferred your shares in Biansham?
Share po. One lang po yun, Your Honor.
Is that one based on the document? No, you do have one share. Okay, noted. So I see it here in the document. So you transferred your share back to Mrs. Myla Roque. Okay. Mr. Chair, let me go back again to my question. I'm trying to figure out the circumstances by which you met Attorney Harry Roque and what's so special about this affiliation that he will make you a stockholder of a company. So may I ask the circumstances by which you met Attorney Harry Roque in 2019, October 2019?
During October of 2019, Your Honor, there was an inauguration in our barangay po. Nagbigyan po kami ng comfort court po ata, which was a project through the office of Attorney Roque when he was still a congressman in the 17th Congress po. During the past po, my mother was a barangay captain po of that barangay and was invited to the inauguration, which was kasama po ako. Then dun ko po na-meet si Attorney Roque po, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, kung naiintindihan ko po, so pumunta si Attorney Harry Roque sa isang inaugurasyon ng covered court sa kanilang barangay, kung saan po barangay captain po ang nanay ni Mr. De La Serna. At pagkatapos noon, dun lang kayo nagkakilala?
Yes po, Your Honor.
Tapos pagkatapos po noon, kinuha ka na po niya na social media?
Hindi po. Nag-work po ako sa kanya ng 2020 po, ng May po.
Bilang?
Socmed person po, Your Honor.
So, tapos, pagkatapos nun, ginawa ka na kaagad niya na stockholder ng...
No, my knowledge was at that time, Your Honor. Parang very limited lang kaming staff na pumapasok that time. So, I was chosen of... isa po na pumirma po to complete the company po.
Ano po ang nauna, Mr. De La Serna? Ginawa po kayong stockholder ng Biansham or in-employ po kayo bilang social media manager?
Na employment po of SOCMED.
Mr. Chair, babalik pa rin po ako doon. Tinatry ko i-establish pero magsiskip muna ako kasi bilang ako, hindi ko iisipin po na bigyan ng stock, ng share sa isang kumpanya yung... tao na kakakilala ko pa lang. So, I'll go back to that, Mr. Chair. Mr. De La Serna, tatanungin ko po yung mga aktibidades nyo po habang kayo ay nominal stockholder ng Biansham. May tanong ko lang po, were you asked to sign documents while you were a part of Biansham?
No po, Your Honor.
Bukod sa ikaw po ay stockholder, naging miyembro din po kayo ng Board of Directors ng Biansham. Tama po ba?
Yes po, Your Honor.
Opo, dahil yun po yung nandito sa dokumento na hawak ko sa submission po ng Biansham, kayo po ay miyembro ng Board of Directors. Nagsabay po ba yung pagkakataon na kayo ay Executive Assistant ni Attorney Harry Roque at kayo ay Board of Director ng Biansham? Sabay po yun?
I'm so sorry po, Your Honor. Hindi ko, I'm not sure, but I guess it's the same. But opo, I'm not 100% sure na yes po yung sagot ko, but it's like 80% sure.
Sige po. Bilang miyembro po ng Board of Directors ng Biansham, are you aware of the transactions na ginagawa po ng corporation?
No, Your Honor.
So, ibig sabihin po, kayo ay stockholder lang, member ng Board of Director by name. Pumipirma po kayo ng mga dokumento nang hindi po alam yung mga nangyayari?
I had full trust and confidence with Attorney Percival po, Your Honor.
Sige po. Alam niyo po ba na ang Biansham ay nagmamay-ari ng shares sa ibang mga korporasyon?
No, Your Honor.
One of these corporations po ay ang First Bataan Madeveles Holding Corp or ang FBMHC. Sinasabi ko lang po at may pagmamay-ari po ang Biansham na 50% ng FBMHC. Aware po ba kayo, Mr. De La Serna, nung panahon na kayo ay member ng Board of Directors ng Biansham, na ang Biansham po ay pumasok sa isang partnership sa Green Mile Realty Corporation?
Yes po, Your Honor.
Aware po kayo?
Yes po.
So, naaalala niyo po na pumirma po kayo ng dokumento na pumapayag po na pumasok ang Biansham sa partnership po sa Green Mile Realty Corp.
Alam ko may pinirman ang document but I'm not sure it was a partnership with Green something po. Hindi ako sure.
So, binabawi niyo po yung kanina?
Alam ko may pinirmahan akong document but I cannot fully say na it was with Green. Yun po yung sinabi niyo.
Mr. Chair, I highlight this because one of the key principal projects of the partnership between Green Mile Realty Corp and Biansham, which then became FBMHC or the First Bataan Marveles Holding Corporation.
Good evening.
So you're enrolled in what flying school? What flying school?
Sorry po, Omni Aviation po.
Sorry?
Mr. Chair. Omni Aviation.
Aviation, di ba?
Yes, tama? Po, tama po, Mr. Chair.
How when was that?
November.
Yung first enrollment mo was when?
November of last year po, Mr.
November 2023.
Yes po, tama po.
Kailan ka pumasok dun sa ano? Sa Pogo Hub?
November din po of the same, of last year po, Mr. Chair.
So after enrollment or before enrollment?
After enrollment po, Mr.
After?
After enrollment po.
After enrollment, so November din, okay?
Yes.
Mr. Chairman, can we direct the COMSEC to check the record of Mr. La Serna to that flying aviation? Ano ba yan? Please repeat.
Omni Aviation po, Mr. Chair.
Omni Aviation. Flying school sa... Anong address nung flying school?
In Clark, Pampanga po, Mr. Chair.
Clark, Pampanga. And until now, you're enrolled in that flying school?
Yes po. I have still a schedule po this week po, Mr. Chair.
Oh, when was the time that you rent a room for a boarding house?
May po, Mr. Chair.
May of?
Of this year po, Mr. Chair.
May of this year?
Yes po.
2024. And our record, kailan ba yung ano raid ng PAOK?
June po, Mr. Ha? Chair.
June? Alam na alam mo ah. So,
po kasi yung gamit ko, Mr.
So hanggang
Chair.
May ka doon, kasi nung June, na-raid na.
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
Do you have an intention if the raid did not happen, do you have an intention to stay there?
No po, Mr. Chair. To be honest po, sabi po sa akin ni kasi for a short time lang because they have a ejectment case nga po sa property nila in... Alam ko talaga Angeles yun, Mr. Chair.
So until May ka lang, when was the time that you rented that room or that boarding house?
Sometime in May po, Mr. Chair.
May din? Anong address?
In Barangay Anonas po, Mr. Chair. In
Barangay?
Anonas po, in Angeles po.
Walang street, walang...
Hindi ako sure, sorry po, hindi ako sure, Mr. Chair.
COMSEC is directed, Mr. Chairman, COMSEC is directed also to check this address. If indeed, Mr. Silisarna is renting that place. Since May. Tama, May, di ba?
Nung May po kasi, Mr. Chair, hindi ako fully nag-rent pa. Nakikistay lang po ako sa...
Tinanong kita kanina, sandali, patapusin mo ako. Ito na ngayon. Huwag kang sumagot kung hindi ka sigurado. Oo, sige. Di ba sabi mo kanina, may ka nagrenta doon? Kaya nga ipapacheck namin sa COMSEC, just to confirm it indeed, nagrenta ka doon sa lugar na yun.
Pwedeng
last May.
Kularuhin ko po, Mr. Chair.
Sorry?
Nung May kasi po, ang dami ko po kasing kaibigan sa flying school. So, ayoko po muna mag-rent talaga kasi nga it's an expense on my part. So, nakikistay muna ako sa mga kaibigan ko.
So, tanong ko ngayon, so, when was the time that you rented that place?
Sinatanong niyo ba, Mr. Chair, is yung if mayroon akong contract of lease, kinaklaro ko lang po para maintindihan ko po yung sinasabi niyo.
Eh, di, kailan ka nag-renta doon?
Actually, hindi ako, nakikistay lang ako sa mga kaibigan ko doon,
Eto, Mr. Chair. Mr. Laserna, sinabi mo kanina, kahit doon sa kay Congressman Sonsing, that you rented. Ngayon, hindi ka nagre-renta. You're just staying in your friends.
Yes po. Ang scheduling po kasi sa flying school po, Mr. Chair, is...
Sandali, I'm not asking you about the schedule of your flying school.
Yes po.
So you denied that you're renting the place. As what you have said when you were being asked by Congressman San Singh?
Pakiulit po, Mr. Chair.
So you deny now your answer to the query of Congressman San Singh?
Nung May po, Mr. Chair, nagstay muna ako sa kaibigan ko po. Tapos, last week lang po ako nag-rent on my own po.
Last week?
Yes.
Anong address?
Yun po yung sa Barangay Anonas po, in Angeles po.
Pag-check lang, Comsec. And during that time, hindi ka na makapasok sa Pogo Hub. That was June of 2024.
Yes po.
Now it's August. Saan ka nakatira ng July? From June to July?
Doon po sa mga kaibigan ko po, Mr. Chair.
Saan yun?
In Angeles din po.
Sino mga kaibigan?
Mga friend ko po sa flying school.
Sino nga ang mga kaibigan?
Allowed ba kung
please state ng... their name.
Allowed ba kung magsabi ng pangalan ng ibang tao, Mr.?
Of course! Can I because we have to invite them.
Can I ask for a legal advice from my legal counsel
yes.
po, Mr. Chair?
Dapat nga eh. Kailan mo lang ang type ito.
Mr.
What's the advice of your lawyer?
I am willing to give their names in private naman po to you.
In?
Po. In private po to you, Mr.
In private?
Yes.
Why in private?
For their privacy naman po, Mr. Chair. That's why I didn't...
Privacy? Defend. Well, in fact, they will be invited in the next hearing.
Actually,
eto, Dela Serna, kanina pinapakinggan lang kita, kaya sabi ko, eto, kung sinungaling ka. And now, I am proving my, yung ano ko lang ha, kanina,
yes,
that you're lying to Congresswoman Sonsing. Now, bakit hindi mo pwedeng sabihin ang pangalan?
Privacy po kasi nila yun, Mr.
Sorry?
Chair. Privacy po nila yun, Mr. Chair.
Ano?
Ayoko po silang idamay dito sa...
What's... Eh, nadamay ka nga dito. Ano, you lied when you tell this committee a few hours ago na nagre-renta ka.
Nag-rent ako.
No, nag-rent ka ngayon lang.
Yes, last week lang po ako nag-rent.
Oh, but I'm
po.
Asking you when Kong Swan Singh asked you, sabi mo nagre-rent ka.
Starting
you never tell this committee na ngayong buwan lang kasi ang critical months is November to May of this year.
Andun po ako sa Angeles po, sa Porac po, na property ng nilak Ma'am Cassie po, Mr. Chair.
Hindi, kaya nga, ang tinatanong ko sa iyo, sino yung kaibigan mo? Why you cannot disclose the names? Oh,
pwede ko pong pag-isipan, Mr. Chair.
Pag-isipan until when? Until you call them? Until you... Alam mo kasi...
Mr. Chair?
Yes, I'm sorry.
It's already past 10 o'clock. If Mr. De La Serna will not answer the question of the Honorable Paduano, I will move that we cite him in contempt. There's nothing involving national security for him not to answer the query of the Honorable Paduano.
Second, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Akop. Mr. De La Serna, this is your last warning. Please answer the query of Congressman Paduano.
Anong pangalan niya? Anong pangalan? AR?
You have 1 minute.
Suspended ba tayo?
AR, may pangalan ba o wala? Are you pretending to think about a name? Kasi, alam mo, nagdududa kami sa actuations mo.
No, Mr. Chair. Ayoko pong idamay yung kaibigan ko po.
Hindi naman siya madadamay. Imbitahan lang po natin siya kung talagang umuupa ka sa kanya. Yun lang naman gusto ni Chairman Paduano.
To be honest po, Mr. Chair, this is very stressful.
Is there really a name or none at all? Kasi yes, it's alam mo, sa tingin namin, you're just pretending na meron kang inuupahan doon. Kasi hindi mo masabi yung pangalan eh. Just tell us the name.
Mr. Chair?
What is the name?
I remember, Mr. Chair. Just to put into context, I was listening intently. The question of Congresswoman Suswan Singh, it was very clear when she asked the witness, why, bakit nandoon yung mga gamit mo? Diba? When the raid happened. Ang sabi niya, in May, he rented a space. I think the raid happened in June. So maybe sometime there, so nag-rent na siya. So ganun talaga yung pagkarinig ko rin na De La Serna, sa nagre-rent ka na dun sa space na yon. I mean, sa just near the ano. So basically, Mr. Chair, she was lying and maybe she lied to Congresswoman Suswan Singh.
Oh, Mr. De La Serna, meron ka pang opportunity before we rule on the motion to cite you in contempt. Pwede bang sagutin mo yung tanong ni Congressman Paduano?
Eman po, Mr. Chair.
Again?
Eman po.
What? Give us the full name.
Eman Jorquales po, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Eman?
Jorquales.
Jordanes.
Quales.
Can you spell the last name, please?
Pwede kong tingnan sa phone ko, Mr. Chair.
Ano, no?
Pwede kong tingnan yung spelling ng family name niya sa phone ko po, Mr. Chair.
Speak louder.
Can I look at my phone for the spelling of his family name?
Yes, as long as you can give us the name, the complete name, the full name of your friend. Friend, Mian?
Eman Jerquales po. Juliet, Uniform, Romeo, Charlie Alpha, Lima Echo Sierra po.
Oh, did you get the full name, Congressman Paduano?
Mr. Chair, we direct the Comsec to get the exact name of that person was mentioned
Comsec,
by Mr.
Comsec, kindly approach the Mr. De La Serna and tell him to give you the full name of his friend.
And Mr. De La Serna.
Including the address, Mr. De La Serna. And contact number.
Sorry po. Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Okay, Mr. De La Serna.
Chairman, can I proceed? Maybe last or two. Mr. De La Serna, binigay mo na ba yung number ng friend mo? Comsec? Nasa iyo na ba?
Phone number.
Mr. De La Serna, pag hindi mo binigay yung exact number, and we will call that number to confirm indeed that number is owned by that person. Balikan kita.
Ah, yes po, Mr. Chair.
Papasahin ka rin contempt ulit ni Chairman Akop.
Ah, yes po, Mr. Chair.
Yung address, binigay mo na ba?
Ah, yes po, Mr. Chair.
Okay, last.
Exact
address. Tapos what's the name? Jorcales? Yes, Jorcales. Jorcales. Oh, ito ah. Mr. Lacerna.
Ah, yes po, Mr. Chair.
Ano, yung mention mo name, kaklase mo?
Kaibigan ko siya from Clark po, Mr. Chair.
Not your classmate?
Ah, no po, Mr. Chair.
Sabi mo kasi kanina, friends.
Friend ko from the Aviation Life ko in Pampanga po, Mr. Chair.
But he's not your classmate?
No po.
Pero sabi mo kanina, friends, who are those other persons? Doon ka ba nakatira sa kanya?
Yes po.
Sino kasama niyo doon sa bahay? Ano ba yun? Apartment?
Yes po. Nirerentahan?
Sir.
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Mr. Lacerna, who pays your tuition and the school expense?
My family pays for it, Mr.
Sorry?
Chair. My family pays for it, Mr. Chair.
Your family? Pamilya mo?
Yes po. Pero may understanding po ko at Mr. Chair na kailan ko po siyang bayaran pag naging pilot po ako, Mr. Chair.
Kanino? Doon sa school?
Sa family ko po, Mr. Chair.
Your mom?
The family of my father po, Mr. Chair.
Pakilakasan mo nga.
The family of my father po, Mr. Chair.
The family of your father.
Mr. Chair, I would like to focus my interpellation to Mr. Arnold Rodolfo de la Serna. My first question is, you became a stockholder of Biancham in 2020. Is that correct?
Yes po, Your Honor.
Who made you a stockholder of Biancham?
To my knowledge, last 2020 po, Your Honor, it was Attorney Percival Ortega po who asked me to sign the document to complete the corporation.
May I ask who Mr. Attorney Percival Ortega is and what is your affiliation to him?
He is a majority stockholder of the company po, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, may I ask why would Mr. Percival Ortega approach you? Out of nowhere, biglang nagsabi, can you sign these documents so we can become a stockholder?
To my knowledge po, Your Honor, makakilala po sila ni Attorney Roque, which is my employer that time po, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, let me go back to the answer of Mr. De La Serna earlier, which is his period of employment as EA of Attorney Harry Roque was from January 2021 to November 2021. Does this mean that you have been employed by Attorney Harry Roque prior to your stint as his executive assistant?
The executive assistant post was available by January 2021 until November 15, 2021 po, Your Honor. But I was previously employed po ni Attorney Roque po. But not as an EA po, but as a SOCMED person po.
May I know your employment? Under what employment contract were you under prior to your EA post in 2021?
We don't have any contract po, Your Honor.
If not...
Can I explain po, sorry po, Your Honor? Ko lang po what did happen. Kasi that time po kasi, Your Honor, nag-antay po ako ng post in the office of the presidential spokesperson. But it was not given until January of 2021 po, Your Honor.
So what was the position prior to 2021? Consultant, personally employed?
I handled the social media of Attorney Roque po, Your Honor.
So the social media, I thought a while ago you said that was under your position as EA3. So were you already performing the function prior to being employed?
I started as the stockmed of Attorney Roque in 2020 po, Your Honor. Then I was given a post by January of 2021 as an executive assistant po at the office of the presidential spokesperson po, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, I would like to ask Mr. De La Serna, when did you meet Attorney Harry Roque? What month and what year?
I met Attorney Harry Roque October of 2019 po, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, I will second the question of Attorney Jinky. What makes you special? Kasi I wonder, you, Attorney Harry Roque met you in October 2019 and he knows Mr. Percival Ortega. And Mr. Percival Ortega approached you to become a stakeholder of Biansham in 2020. One stakeholder ni Mr. Percival Ortega. Is it because of your affiliation to Mr. Harry Roque?
Maybe that is because po, I really don't know the answer po. Bakit ako yung napili po, Madam Chair?
Mr. Chair, I would like to ask because you will not accept a post without an offer. So what was in exchange of that? Pirma ka ng mga documents para maging stockholder. Ano yung in-offer sa'yo? Were you offered a compensation?
To my knowledge, wala pong compensation yun, Your Honor, in any kind po. To my knowledge po, Your Honor. Because it was just, I do not know, completing for the 5-month law of corporation po, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, if I hear that correctly, you agreed to becoming a stockholder by name, without any compensation, without any responsibilities, without any official responsibilities, Mr. Chair, walang buy-in, no nothing?
I would like to seek counsel to my legal counsel po, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair?
Hello po, Mr. Chair. I would like to seek legal advice from my legal counsel po, Mr. Chair.
Do you have your lawyer with you?
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
What is his name?
His name is Attorney San Agustin po.
Where is Attorney San Agustin? Attorney, can you please enter your appearance before the committee?
Mr. Chair, Kevin San Agustin from the Law Office of Rojas San Agustin and Yason, Your Honor. Respectfully entering my appearance for Mr. De La Serna.
Okay, thank you. Pakiulit lang ulit yung law firm, yung law office.
That's Rojas San Agustin and Yason, Your Honor.
Rojas?
San Agustin and Yason, Your Honor.
Rojas San Agustin and Yason. Thank you. AR, please reply.
Mr. Chair?
Congressman Akop muna.
May I ask the lawyer who contacted his services?
Attorney?
Mr. Chair, I'm sorry, I did not catch the question.
Who contacted you to be the lawyer of Mr. De La Serna?
Attorney Roque, Your Honor.
Okay. So Attorney Roque was the one who engaged your law firm to be the lawyer of Mr. De La Serna?
May I clarify, Your Honor? May I be allowed to explain, Your Honor?
No, but
kindly, Mr. Chair,
please proceed.
There's a question asked, and therefore, as a lawyer, he should answer that first before he explains.
Yes, Your Honor. Sorry, Your Honor, could you please repeat the question?
My question, the question of Congressman Akop is who contacted you to be the lawyer of Mr. De La Serna? And you replied it was Attorney Roque, correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
And you have an engagement contract with Mr. De La Serna?
No, Your Honor.
Are you doing this pro bono for Mr. De La Serna?
Yes, Your Honor.
Please proceed, Congresswoman Sonsing.
Mr. Chair, let me repeat my question to Mr. A.R. De La Serna. You agreed to be a stockholder by name of Biansham without any buy-in, without any compensation, no dividends, no promise of any offer. Just by name, no responsibilities. When you were approached by Mr. Percival Ortega to sign the incorporation documents.
I would like to ask my legal counsel for advice for that, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, it is a yes or no question. So, Mr. Chair, I will defer to you whether or not you will allow Mr. De La Serna to confer with his counsel. yun lang po. Wala po kayong natatanggap na compensation galing po kay Attorney Hadadoke.
From Bensham po ba yung tanong niyo, Your Honor?
O yung tulong, hindi siya tumutulong sa iyo ngayon?
He endorsed me to Attorney San Agustin po. Actually, ang first meeting namin ni Attorney San Agustin is not...
Sorry, Mr. Del Sen, could you speak closer to the mic, please?
To be honest po, Your Honor, the first time na nag-meet kami ni Attorney San Agustin is not to represent me in Senate or in Congress, but to file a motion to quash to get my stuff in PORAC po. Kasi kailangan ko na talaga yung mga naiwan ko pong gamit doon because as I progress on my flying school, naiwan ko po doon yung mga mapa ko at most of my uniform is still there din po.
Sorry, Mr. Chair. Iba po yung tanong ko. Mayroon po ba kayong natatanggap ngayon?
Aside from the endorsement of Attorney Raketo na tulungan ako ni Attorney San Agustin, no po, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair, siguro po, one of the questions that I have is why the preferential treatment to Mr. A.R. De La Serna? Is it because nakita po na he's someone who would sign documents, who would enter into agreements, willing to be an incorporator by name? Siguro po yun po siguro yung iniisip ko, Mr. Chair, kasi nahihirapan ako na maniwala na pinipirmahan ni Mr. A.R. De La Serna itong mga dokumento na ito nang walang kinukonsulta. Dahil mahahalaga po itong mga dokumento na ito. So, Sir, Mr. Chair, ang mahalagang tanong po nitong ating komite ay sino po yung talagang rinirepresenta ni Mr. A.R. De La Serna? Kaninong interes po? Kasi posible po na merong personalidad, Mr. Chair, na dahil merong mga may mga restrictions, halimbawa po para po sa mga government officials, hindi po tayo pwedeng pumasok sa mga particular na mga transactions, kaya po kailangan po merong pribadong individual na tatayo para sa atin sa mga ganong mga transaction. Posibleng yun po yung position ni Mr. A.R. De La Serna. So, I don't want to use the term, Mr. Chair, pero meron kasing gumagamit ng mga dummy or proxies na para humarap po sa mga transaction dito po sa mga korporasyon na to. At mahalaga po para sa ating komite na malaman sino po itong personalidad na ito. Mr. Chair, I will continue to probe Mr. A.R. De La Serna on what that other corporation is that he is a stakeholder of. Kaya Mr. A.R. De La Serna, babalikan ka namin before the end of this hearing. Check your emails, check your text messages. We need to know what that other corporation is na you're part of.
Yes po, Your Honor.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Thank you very much for the opportunity to propound questions to our resource persons.
Mr. De La Serna. I remember you testified before. I just don't know if it is before this committee or before the Senate. Tumira ka sa Lucky South. Do you confirm?
Yes po, Your Honor. Good evening po.
Can you enlighten us again? Bakit ka dun tumira sa Lucky South?
Pakiulit po, Your Honor.
You stayed, you lived, you resided in the premises of Lucky South.
Yes, Your Honor. I lived in that property because I am currently a student pilot in the aviation school in Clark po, Your Honor.
You were a student of aviation?
An aviation school. Kahit ngayon po, Your Honor, I'm currently a student in an aviation school in Pampanga.
But during the time that you were still living in Lucky South, bakit ka tumira doon?
Because I am studying in a aviation school in Pampanga po, Your Honor.
I see. You lived inside the premises of Lucky South because you were studying aviation in Pampanga.
Yes po, I'm currently a student pilot po in Pampanga.
Please limit your answer to the questions.
Yes.
Now, Mr. De La Serna, can you tell us the inclusive date when you were living inside the premises of Lucky South? Kailan ka nag-umpisa at kailan natapos yung pagtira mo sa Lucky South?
To my knowledge po, Your Honor, ay, nang first ko pong dating sa property po was on... Can I check my calendar po, Your Honor?
Just the approximate date, Mr. De La Serna.
Around November po ako first nagpunta po.
November, that is 2000?
2023 po, last year po, Your
November
Honor.
November 2023 until?
Andun pa po yung gamit ko until now po, Your Honor.
Until now, until the raid?
Yes po, Your Honor.
Mabuti hindi ka nasama sa raid.
Andun lang po yung mga gamit ko, Your Honor, but meron na pong nakitang rent, room for rent in Pampanga.
Are you trying to tell us na nung nag-conduct ng raid, hindi ka na nakatira doon sa Lucky South?
Yes po, Your Honor, pero andun po yung iba pong gamit po.
So, saan ka nakatira nung nagkaroon ng raid sa Lucky South?
I rent a place po near my school na po, Your Honor.
In other words, kaya ka wala dun sa lugar during the raid dahil ibang lugar na ang tinitirahan mo, tama?
Yes po, Your Honor.
And can you please tell us, are you paying for the lodging in Lucky South?
No po, Your Honor.
So you were staying in Lucky South for free, tama?
Tama po, Your Honor.
And how far is Lucky South from your aviation school?
10 to 15 minutes po, Your Honor.
10 to 15 minutes. So, it is close. Tama?
Yes, Your Honor.
And who allowed you to live inside Lucky South?
Ang kinakusap ko is Ma'am Cassandra Leong po, Your Honor.
Which means, Mr. De La Serna, kapag may titirang mga tao sa Lucky South, it is Cassie Ong who decides.
Yun ang hindi ko po. But in my case po, Your Honor, siya po yung kausap ko.
Sa iba, aside from you, may iba pa bang nakikitira dun sa Lucky South?
Hindi ko po alam, Your Honor.
But based on your daily observation, syempre, dun ka nakatira. Umuwi ka dun, umaalis ka dun. That is your daily routine.
Yes,
wala
sir.
Ka bang ibang nakikita o napapansin na nakatira other than you?
Nakastay ako sa lodging houses ng employees nila, Your Honor. So, may nakikita naman po akong tao, Your Honor.
Are you an employee of Lucky South?
No po, Your Honor.
So, do you confirm na ikaw ang nag-iisang pinatira na hindi naman empleyado ng Lucky South?
I can only confirm na nag-stay po ako doon, Your Honor. Pero if may iba pong nag-stay doon, I cannot confirm po.
But at least you can confirm wala ka ng ibang kilala na hindi empleyado na pinatira doon sa Lucky South. Tama?
Yes po, Your Honor.
What is so special about you? Bakit ka pinatira doon ng Lucky South?
I was properly introduced by my previous employer po, Attorney Roque po, Your Honor.
And who is Attorney Roque to Cassandra Ong?
Ang alam ko po, Your Honor, he handles the ejection case of Whirlwind Corporation po.
He handles the case for ejection.
Yes po.
Ejectment.
Yes po, Your Honor.
And of course, si Cassie Ong, may iba naman silang mga lawyers eh. Pero bakit walang ibang pinatitira doon na mga empleyado? Why only you?
Nakatira po ako doon, Your Honor, because I need a place to stay because I am a student pilot in Pampanga.
I know, but there are a lot of people who needs a place to stay as well, for free, the same as you. Anong dahilan at pinatira ka doon ni Cassandra Ong? What is extraordinary about you? Bakit hindi siya nagpatira nung iba? Marami din ang nangangailangan ng libreng tirahan. Do you understand that, Mr. De La Serna?
Yes po, Your Honor. I cannot answer that, Your Honor, kasi I am not the decision maker naman po, Your Honor.
But at least you can confirm na sa iyong pagkakaalam, wala ka ng ibang nakita na hindi empleyado na pinatira sa loob ni Kasiong. Tama? It's just a yes or a no.
Before I answer that, Your Honor, I want to say that wala po akong kakilala po doon sa loob po ng compound.
Wala kang ibang kilala except for Kasiong.
Ah, yes po, Your Honor.
And the reason kung bakit tumira ka doon is because Kasiong has the authority to decide for Lucky South. Tama? Yes. Otherwise, hindi ka makakatira sa loob ng Lucky South.
Okay po, Your Honor.